The road to recovery is still underway in Greenfield. It was hit by a powerful tornado in late May. Some people in the weather community have disagreement about how that tornado was rated. Good evening. I'm Aaron Kiernan.
I'm Elias Johnson. We hope you enjoyed the opening ceremonies for the Olympics. But let's get into these news stories now. And how does the rating process work? I clearly do not have any clue, but we do know the professor is in today, meteorologist Gabe Pro, to explain why the Greenfield tornado will be remembered regardless of what the rating is assigned.
Yeah, we're going to explain it for you, Elias, so no worries there. Tornadoes are rated on a scale from EF-0 to EF-5, with 0 being the lowest and 5 the highest or strongest. The scale attempts to tie damage to tornado wind speeds to determine the strength. But as the Greenfield tornado illustrates, it can be a complicated process.
Most of the debris may be cleaned up, but it's still clear something very bad happened in Greenfield.
It was chilling. It's not often that you see damage of that scale and that magnitude impact one of the communities that you're here to serve. It was incredible damage, absolutely devastating, as we've all seen. And walking through that and through the debris that day was unlike anything I've ever experienced.
The National Weather Service rated the tornado as an EF-4, estimating wind speeds up to 185 miles per hour. But a crew of research meteorologists estimated wind speeds over 300 miles per hour with a mobile radar, which would push the tornado into EF-5 territory. But tornado ratings aren't that simple.
The enhanced Fujita scale is a damage scale, and so we have to be reliant upon the damage that is caused by the tornado. And so it does depend on what sort of structures are hit as to what sort of rating we're able to assign.
The rating system has its flaws.
If every building that the tornado hits could be destroyed by an EF2 or an EF3, so they weren't designed by engineers to be able to withstand 200 mile per hour winds, then when the tornado destroys them, all we know is, well, the wind was at least EF2 or EF3 strength, and that's the kind of rating that we have to assign.
That can lead to mixed feelings among meteorologists and surveyors.
Deep down, anybody who saw the radar, who witnessed those tornadoes, know they would have caused EF5 damage if there had been, say, a hospital or school or some very strong building.
So when some insist the Greenfield tornado wasn't properly rated, Han replies,
the EF scale is a wind estimate, and we're talking about the difference of 10, 15 miles per hour in the different levels of ratings. And so what I would say, it's a possibility, but the damage didn't support it that we saw on our ground-based survey.
Regardless of the technicalities of the rating assigned, the impact on those living in Greenfield is still the same.
No matter what wind speed, all that other stuff, it was a vicious tornado that came through here, and a lot of people lost everything.
That's a good reminder there, as Mayor Schultz points out. The human impact in Greenfield is still terrible, whether or not the tornado was officially classified as an EF5. In fact, tornadoes EF2 and higher are all lumped into the same category, known as significant tornadoes, because of their damaging impact. And it's a reminder that all tornadoes are dangerous. So we want you to head to your safe spot when tornado warnings are issued.
Yeah, it's, even EF0 causes damage, as we've just learned as well. Very interesting stuff, Professor Pro. We really appreciate that perspective. It helps everybody get a little better understanding, and keep them coming.